Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Ivan Sokolov and Taiga Persson. This game was played in Denmark. In 1997, Ivan Sokolov had white pieces and he started with d4. Taiga Persson played g6, going for the modern defense. e4, bishop to g7, knight to c3, d6, bishop to e3, black to move. a6 was played, very popular move. Black is intending b5. This is especially useful if white wants to castle queenside. Queen to d2, knight to d7, h4 intending h5, h5 stopping h5 by white, knight to h3, b5, knight to g5, bishop to b7, a4, black to move. Taiga Persson played c6. If b4 is played, what happens then? Then there was a game where white played bishop to c4 and got an advantage. Play with black pieces played e6, but what happens if pawn takes knight? Then bishop takes on f7 check, and after king to f8, queen takes on c3. White is threatening knight to e6 check, winning the queen. After queen to b8, bishop takes on g6, and white is better. Back to our game. So, Taiga Persson played c6. Rook to d1. That means that white will not castle queenside. Queen to c7. f4. Knight to h6. Bishop to e2. Knight to f6. Bishop to f3. Knight from f to g4. And Sokolov castled kingside. d5. E takes on d5. If e5, then knight to f5. And the knight is very nicely placed on f5. So, e takes on d5 was played. Instead of c takes on d5, Taiga Persson played knight to f5, attacking the bishop. Bishop to f2, rook to d8, d takes on c6, rook takes on d4, attacking white queen. Knight to d5. It is becoming complicated. Black to move. Black must be very careful now. If rook takes queen on d2, then knight takes queen on c7, check, and white is winning. Queen takes pawn on c6. Looks very risky too. How would you continue in this position if you had black pieces? After carefully calculating, Taiga Persson captured on c6. This is very complex now. White to move. Queen to a5 was played. Sokolov first wants to find a safe spot for the queen before moving the knight. Of course, he analyzed something like knight takes on e7, attacking the queen. But then queen to d7. After white queen moves to safety, knight takes on e7, bishop takes on d4, bishop takes on d4, check, king to h1, castling, and it is unclear who is better. Back to our game. So, queen safety first. Queen to d6. White to move. This is a very important moment of the game. Sokolov was choosing between knight to c7 check and knight to e4 attacking the queen. And to him, knight to e4 looked like a better move. Knight to e4 attacking the queen. Black to move. This is now the most critical position of the game. It looks like that black queen must go to b8. This seems to be the safest spot for the queen. What would you do? Okay, let's have a look what happens if queen goes to b8. Then one line goes like this. Bishop takes on d4. Bishop takes on d4 check. Rook takes on d4. Knight takes on d4. Queen to b6. White is better. One line goes like this. The knight on d4 is under attack. So knight takes on f3 makes sense. This is check. But now, not rook takes knight. Pawn takes knight. Attacking the knight on g4. And where is the knight going? If the knight goes to a safe spot, let's say h6, then knight from d to f6 check. Pawn takes knight. Knight takes on f6 check. If king goes to f8, then knight to d7 check, winning the queen. If king goes to e7, then rook to e1 check. And after king to f8, the same thing. Check, and white wins the queen. So, queen to b8 doesn't work. What works then? If queen takes on d5, then knight to f6 check, and then white wins the queen. Is black in trouble? Well, Tiger Persson played queen takes on d5, walking into this move. Knight to f6 check. Bishop takes on f6. Bishop takes on d5. But now, excellent move. Knight takes on f2, removing dark square bishop. So black dark square bishop has no opposition now. Bishop takes on b7. Knight takes on d1. A takes on b5. And Tiger Persson casted kingside. Just a man and his will to survive. It is a thrill of the fight, rising to the challenge of your rival. Have you heard of this before? White to move. c3. Now, perhaps, rook move was expected. Knight from d to e3 was played. B takes on a6. Let's take it back. What if c takes on d4? Then bishop takes on d4. And this position favors black. Let's see how. Now, black is already threatening. Knight to c4 check, winning white queen. So if queen goes to d2 to avoid trouble, then knight to g4 check. King to h1. Knight to g3 checkmate. Wow. Perhaps then king doesn't go to h1. Rook goes to f2. Then bishop takes on f2 check. And now if king goes to f1, then there is a checkmate just like that. And if king goes to h1, then again, knight to g3, checkmate. Back to our game. So, Sokolov didn't touch the rook on d4. He played pawn takes pawn on a6. And it appears that white will get a new queen soon. Rook to d7. Bishop to c6, attacking the rook. Rook to d2. Rook to b1. Bishop takes on h4. And white king is feeling extremely uncomfortable. Bishop to f3. How would you continue now if you had black pieces? Tiger continued with bishop to f2 check. King to h1. Knight to g4, threatening knight to g3 checkmate. For example, if you play a random move, knight to g3 checkmate. White king can't go to h2. That is why bishop takes on g4 was played. So after knight to g3 check, the king can go to h2. H takes on g4. And now c4, threatening queen takes rook. What is the best square for the rook? What would you do? please pause and find the move, that amazing move the tiger person played in this position. Did you pause? What did you find? Tiger person moved his king to g7. What a move, what a move. And now if queen takes rook, then rook to h8 checkmate. Queen to e5 was played. This is check. Black played a move and white resigned. Tiger played f6. Sokolov resigned. There is no sensible defense against rook to h8 check. For example, if queen to c3, intending even to play queen to h3 after rook to h8, then first g3 and then rook to h8 checkmate. If queen takes on g3, knight takes on g3 check, and after king to h2, rook to h8 checkmate. The rumor says that tournament organizers couldn't pack the pieces after the game because pieces were too hot to handle. What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.